Good day. I'm going to give this another attempt. The other day, I needed to paint, and my video camera stopped working just after I started. But in this painting, I used this thread. And I had some silicone in the black. Other than that, all these paintings that I'm going to show you are titanium white, Mars black, mixed with Floetrol, and they're Saxe paints. So then, the next one I did to show you how I did that one was this one. Except I couldn't find my string, so in this one, I didn't use any silicone, and I used this heavier jute cord. And it definitely gave a different effect, and all I did was get it wet with paint and pull it in. So now, I'll show you the one that I did get to record. Kind of stuck here, which the video will be following for. Now in this one, I use this string and black paint, or the same black and white paint, and I just wet this string and pulled it through. But you can see the video on this one. Anyway, being as I'm having so much trouble with my videos, I thought I'd just throw that in so you kind of understood that they're all kind of doing the same processes with different strings. Anyway, thanks. Good day. Today I'm going to practice a little more with my string art. I finally found the butcher string that I usually use. And I'm going to try some more irises today because I'm going to get good at these yet. Now today I'm going to kind of work on, I'm going to try to do 3 irises. So let's get started. I'm going to get my first petal. Pull it towards. And bring it up. Now I'm going to have a cup here to ring it into, because if I don't, I'm going to have white in my black. So every time I use my string, I'm just going to squeeze it off into this cup. I should have my towel on my lap. Wet my thread again. But I'm going to try to keep it in little manageable pieces so I can work and bring one in. Now this I have no silicone in. I just have black paint with some Floetrol. I wanted to do one without silicone, because with the other one you could really see the silicone made a big difference. But I do find when I'm making these flowers I have to keep turning this, otherwise I'm not getting my petals the right way. No, there's another one that comes here. I'm going to bring that one in. Bring it off. Now this one I'm going to try to go backwards. I don't know if I can. I'll try. And I kind of did. You have to make sure that white paint on your background isn't too heavy. Now I'm going to turn it again so I can bring these other petals up. And in. And sometimes I might have to do them twice, but we'll see. I'm just finding it's easier to work with a shorter string than it is a longer string. Okay. Now wring your string off. And I'm going to bring another one in from down here. Gently pull it in, wring my string off again. Seems like a lot of string wringing, but now I'm going to bring one up from the bottom. First, I think I should pull kind of a stem out. Just a ways, just because otherwise when I pull this, if I don't have the stem already kind of there, then it's not behind, and I want it behind. So I'm going to try it this way. Just gently pulling it up. And I might put another one there. But there is quite a difference when there's no silicone. You can really see you get a different effect. Can't ya? Now I think I'm going to pull one in from the other way just because I think that looks pretty cool. Turn it around again and bring the next one in. Now I should have, I had a stick here before, which I'm going to have to grab one. I always think you're prepared, but of course when it comes to doing it, you're not as prepared as you ever think you are. I'm going to try to kind of pull this down a bit. With the other ones, what I did, but I think I had a little silicone or something. Kind of brought it down and made a stem. Now I need to put some leaf, one leaf on this one. Now what I did to make the leaves was I made them thinner and longer. So let's see if I can do that this time. Kind of dropped it like that and brought it down. And then pulled it into the stem. Doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to give you the impression of a leaf. try one down here too. I'm just going to try pulling it out. And you get a different effect that way. Okay. Now I'm ready to put my next iris on. And my board is crooked, but... first petal. And you will get different effects every time because you pull it differently every time. Right? We can't help it. On this one I'm going to try to pull both to a certain extent. Clean it off. Bring another one in. And I think I'm going to try to bring one in this way. See if I can do it sideways. Into the center. It's not as easy. As you can see, pulling sideways. Person's almost better turning their canvas and doing it that way. Make sure you get enough, just a little bit of paint, not a ton. I'm going to try to pull this one up and in. As somebody commented in my last one, they're not perfect. I think I really, really liked the first one I did, and it just worked, so I guess I had the paint set right, everything right, and it just... But sometimes it's the mood we're in, sometimes it's how we're doing it, how thick the paint is. Big difference. And, like I said, just kind of practice until you get what you like. Okay, I'm going to put another one here. Then I'm going to wring off my string. See if I can bring kind of a thread down. Just let it lay the way it wants to go. Start pulling it out. I can follow through when I get the other way. One up and in. Now I may look at them after and dot some paint in the centers, but wait and see. Okay, I'm going to turn it again. I'm going to go. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to pull a leaf down here. And out. looks like it fits. Should fit in with each other. And you can't have, you must have more than two. Gonna come down and off. Because I think every one of my art teachers, such as the Art Shepra, Painting with Jane, Clive Five Art, all of them talk about making sure you, your composition, nothing too, it's got to be odd numbers. Odd numbers is what works. Even numbers don't work. And the reason even numbers don't work is because it, yes, the composition disturbs your eyes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull another leaf because I need more up there. I need something up here to pull in and down. Where I should be using my little forky thing. Then I can get my tail down here. And it kind of helps finish off your stems as you go. This one down a little. I like that effect. That is so cool. I hope you guys try these because they're not as easy as some of the things we do. But yet it's so satisfying when you get something that you really like. And I guess I can say I'm determined to master these flowers. I don't know why. I'm trying in different ways. I guess because I think they're pretty. Especially done in black and white is just so, it just grabs your attention. Doesn't it? Well, it does mine. And you get something different. What I like is getting something different than everybody else has all the time. Or at least trying something different. Find your niche. Find out what you like. Because you know, all of us don't like the same things. We just don't. Some people love flowers. Some people think you're crazy to paint a flower. Now, there is, as you well notice, quite a difference with no silicone. I mean, you get a completely I don't know how to explain it, just a different look. Somehow I have to fix that stem up, I will, so that I'm happy with it. Just bring that down. Bring it in. Bring it over. I'm still not crazy about it. And the knots. Oh. Oh, there's my black covering. I think I'm done with this for now. I'm just going to take my I try to save this because I might practice another one. I'm gonna get good at these yet. Now what I have found is I can take and touch up where I want to too. I can take my white and dip it in. Put it where, touch up the places where I've, see, that's the thing with working with black and white. If you touch the black anywhere, you have stained it. So what I'm going to try to do is just bring this stem in the way I want it. Just by pulling it in. Careful, because I will can make more of a mess than fix things to them. I'm not careful. As we all know, it's not always, it's easy to make a mess sometimes, but it's not always as easy to You know, I think I'm just going to do some little trips. For the center. But you know, just might add that little bit of drip, but that's all right. I think I better stop while I'm ahead before I really mess it up. As you know how it goes. Every time you don't stop, that is when you mess it up. Make sure I haven't got any black on the sides. And, you know, I like it. I'm going to keep playing with this string until I get it the way I like. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you try one. Please like, share, and subscribe. And keep on pouring.